very true. Very good points right here. So I think what's interesting about Tupac and hip-hop in general, if we really dissect hip-hop, okay? Hip-hop, and this is going to probably blow your mind, hip-hop was created by the United States government.
I believe that.
Hip-hop.
The conditions.
Yeah, the conditions, inadvertently. So let's go back in time a little bit. So we're talking slave ships dock, okay? Stole from your homeland. Built through slavery for over 300 years. Slavery, I don't say ended, I say slavery transitioned. 13th Amendment says slavery is over except if you're found guilty of a crime. So it transitions to, say factories, maybe. You can also say the prison yards. So 26 in California, everybody there is a slave. Go to where I'm at in Joliet right now, Statesville, everybody's a slave. You know, so there's really no type of change in that way. And then when blacks start to prosper, every time they do, they get held back. Victims of terrorism, victims of violence, but they still make ends meet. Then they start to move to the north for better opportunities. When they try to get to those neighborhoods with more resources, what happens? Redlining. Government instituted policies that said you can't get a loan like whites can. So that means you grow up in an area full of poverty. Then the liquor stores come. Then the gangs come.
Yes.
So the government inadvertently created gangs.
Yes.
Crips and Bloods, GDs, Vice Lords,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
And then hip hop comes after the civil rights movement because we needed a voice. It was a plea for help, and it was also a way to express ourselves and have fun. And all of that is coming out from Tupac. So when you hear hip hop, I want you to actually think of it like you're hearing different perspectives of undiagnosed trauma.
Yes.
If you grew up in the hood, you're traumatized somewhere. I grew up in the hood.
Yes.
The only thing that flipped my perspective was, one, my mom's an educator, and she kept books in front of me. She kept images like this in my house. But also being exposed to different rappers. My sister, she would always have like rappers like Common and Nas and, you know, Dead Prez and these, and I was young, I didn't want to hear that. It was too many words. I just wanted to hear some stuff like MC Hammer or whatever, you know? I didn't want to hear all that.
James Brown.
Right. But as I got older, those lyrics that were a part of me kind of made me reflect. And I went back to that same music. And I'm like, man, they're really saying something to make me think. And on the flip side, you also have people I grew up listening to.